This lovely pony is Basil, and he belongs to a friend of mine. Basil often seems very, very fit, but as though the muscles don't slide and glide quite as you like them to. The little snort that you saw there, you could see how there wasn't a lot of movement in his body, and it's almost like he doesn't fully exhale. He let go a little bit there, and that was the moment where he decided that maybe he would engage in this session a little bit more fully, tell me where to go and what he needed. In my work, I was focusing on creating a safe space for Basil, helping him feel more comfortable and loose in his body through soft myofascial techniques, and generally observing his behavior and attuning to the tissues, not doing anything confronting. And this was actually our second session, and it was nice to see that some of the changes from the first had stuck for him. In this session, he wanted a lot of work around his tail, and the tail has an impact all the way up the spine through the deepest muscles there, the core stabilizers, very important for proprioception and stability of the spine. He really felt some feelings and blissed out for this work. What's really fascinating is how much of an impact you can have by doing so little. And this is why all of my work focuses around creating a safe space first. If the animal involved, people involved, you, if you don't have a sense of safety, a felt sense of safety in the environment with the people you're interacting with and within your body, how can you possibly function at your fullest and your happiest? So creating a sense of safety. For most of the session at the start, Basil was eating and paying me no attention, so by this point he really was actually engaging, which let me do a little bit of work around the head as well, the poll, the TMJ, the forehead, and a tiny bit of work around his mouth. He had given me a good amount of benefit of the doubt and patience by this point and let go a little bit. So then it was a bit of a giggle to me when he quite definitively said he was finished, which was lovely. Any communication is a lovely thing from a pony. By the end of the session, Basil's body looked less like a tank. There was more looseness. You can see the length increase through his neck, more space around the scapula to the neck there, and in those little blows just before, he was exhaling more fully. We went for a little walk around the arena afterwards, because mobilizing the body gently after bodywork really is the most important part. You can release things and make things feel better, but if the nervous system doesn't know it can use that information, then it's going to be possibly useless. So we had a little walk around the arena, and Basil explored his walk in ways that he doesn't usually. He would reach over his back, drop his nose to the floor. He was more uphill, longer strides. You can see that lovely length through the neck. And he even took some lateral steps when sniffing along the arena fence line, picking at weeds.